Good day, grading student. It's me once again, Sir Harrold, your arts teacher from Big Nine National High School, and welcome to the world of Western classical plays and operas. Theater began from myth, ritual, and ceremony. Early society perceived connections between actions performed by groups of people or leaders to a certain society, and these actions moved from habit to tradition, to ritual, to ceremony due to human desire and need for entertainment. The repeated rehearsals, performances, and creations of different actions broke the ground for theater. Theater means place of scene, but it is more than the building where performance takes place. To produce theater, a playwright writes the scripts. The director rehearses the performers. The designers and technical crew produce props to create the scene. And actors and actresses perform on stage. Then, it will only be through theater act when an audience witnesses it. We are now in the last quarter of our subject. And today, as we continue another art-amazing experience awaits you, as we unveil the different theatrical art forms, elements and principles of arts, and uniqueness in terms of visual and performance art form of the Western classical plays and opera. But before we go, let us first be reminded once again with the protocol to follow during the live streaming class.
Protocols to follow during the live streaming class. Respect everyone. Agree to recognize and abide the protocols in the live stream and respect the feelings, rights, or traditions of each and every one. No hate speech. Do not express or discourage violence towards a person or group based on something such as race, religion, sex, or sexual orientation. Be guided with the anti-cyberbullying law. Make sure that everyone feels safe. Bullying of any kind isn't allowed. And regarding comments about things such as race, religion, culture, sexual orientation, gender or identity will not be tolerated. No promotion of products or items. Give more to this group than you take. Selling of products, self-promotion, spam, and irrelevant links aren't allowed. Use appropriate words in giving suggestions, comments, and queries. We're all in this together to create a welcoming environment. Let's treat everyone with respect. Healthy debates are natural, but kindness is required. After the FB live streaming, attend discussion class in the FB Messenger classroom with the subject teacher. Maximize the features of FB Messenger to be used in FB Messenger classrooms such as text chat, audio calls, video rooms, and multiple screen sharing.
I hope everyone will be guided by the protocols for us to maintain order during this session. So allow me to give you the competencies that you are about to learn in this video. At the end of the lesson, you are expected to identify the selected theatrical forms from the different art periods, research on the history of theatrical forms and their evolution, identify the elements and principles of art as manifested in Western classical plays and operas, and last, defines what makes selected Western classical plays and operas unique through visual presentation. Before we proceed with our lesson, let us go back on your previous lesson that have been discussed when you are in grade 7 by playing a game entitled Elements in Theater Arts. Try to classify the given elements used in theater arts in each category that I will show you in this activity. I will reveal the answer after 15 seconds. By the way, theater arts are a collaborative art form which combines words, voice, movements, and visual elements to express meaning. Are you ready? Let's begin. First category: basic elements of musical play or theater. These elements are used to create a musical play or theater. The basic elements of musical play or theater are character, dialogue, music, plot, and theme. Second category: elements of artistic expressions. These are essential elements to express the artistic aspects in a musical play or theater. Elements of artistic expressions are color, line, movement, rhythm, sound, space, and texture. Third category: tools for an actor or actress. These tools are used to show their best performances in acting. Actor or actress are body, emotion, and voice. Congratulations, dear student! You always amaze me. We will go back on the different periods or eras that have been discussed in the previous quarters in Arts 9. We will recognize it in our activity called Throughout Time. In this activity, arrange in chronological order of the following periods or eras. Write the letters in the correct sequence, and you will be given 15 seconds to key in your answer in our comment section. We have A, ancient period, B, baroque period, C, medieval period, D, neoclassic period, E, Renaissance period, and F, Romantic period. Are you ready? Your 15 seconds timer will start now. And here is the correct sequence of the following periods. It's great that you arranged the sequence correctly. Good job! Before you get fully excited, you may want to participate in our short activity by typing your answer to each number in our comment section. In this activity, arrange the jumbled letters to form a word in 5 seconds. Are you ready? Number 1. Someone who writes plays. Did you answer playwright? You are right. Number two. A theatrical piece that tells a story totally through the music. The correct answer is opera. Number three. It refers to a play with an unhappy ending. If your answer is tragedy, you are right. Number four. Refers to light and humorous drama with happy ending. Did you answer comedy? You are correct. For the last jumbled letters, these refer to an ancient Greek burlesque with a chorus of satyr. It's satyr play. Great job! Welcome back to ancient theater. European theater began in ancient Greece. It began around 700 BC with festivals honoring their many gods, such as Dionysus, the god of wine and fertility. This religious festival was called the Cult of Dionysus. The city-states of Athens was the center of significant cultural, political, and military power during this period, and where the festivals and competitions were usually performed. The three well-known Greek tragedy playwrights were Sophocles, Euripides, and Aeschylus. The theater of ancient Greece consisted of three types of drama: tragedy, comedy, and the satyr play. Tragedy is a compound of two Greek words, tragos, or goat, and ode, meaning song, referring to goat sacrificing to Dionysus before performances, or the goatskins worn by the performers. In Greece, tragedy was the most admired type of play. It dealt with tragic events and have an unhappy ending, especially one concerning the downfall of the main character. Thespis was the first actor and introduced the use of masks and was called the father of tragedy. The actors, directors, and dramatists were all the same person. After some time, only three actors could perform in each play. Due to limited numbers of actors allowed on stage, the chorus played a very active part of Greek theater. Music was often played during the chorus. Men performed songs to welcome Dionysus, and women were not allowed to perform. Competitions in song, dance, music, scenic representation, and bodily exercises were done during the festivals. And to promote a common identity, Athenians spread this festival to their numerous allies. Comedy plays were derived from imitation. There were no traces of their origin. Aristophanes wrote most of the comedy plays. Out of these 11 plays, Lysistrata survived. A humorous tale about a strong woman who led a female coalition to end war in Greece. Cyclops, an adventure comedy by Euripides. Theater plays contain comic elements to lighten the overall mood, or serious play with a happy ending. A theater play was a short, light-hearted tale piece performed after each trilogy of the tragedy. It is an ancient Greek form of tragic comedy. It featured half-men, half-goat characters known as satyrs. They were awful, ridiculous, and usually drunk. The satyr characters lasted after everyone on stage, and they delivered the most humorous lines, and often at the expense of others. The theaters were large, open-air structure constructed on the slope of hills. The major components of Greek theaters are labeled on the diagram. Orchestra. The orchestra, which literally means dancing space, was normally circular. It was a level space where the chorus would dance, sing, and interact with the actors who were on the stage near the scene. The earliest orchestra were simply made of hard earth, but in the classical period, some orchestras began to fit with marble and other materials. In the center of orchestra, there was often a female or altar. The orchestra of the Theater of Dionysus in the Athens was about 60 feet in diameter. Theatron. The theatron, literally viewing place, is where the spectators sat. The theatron was usually part of the hillside, overlooking the orchestra, and often wrapped around a large portion of the orchestra. Spectators in the 5th century BC probably sat on cushions or boards, but by the 4th century, the theatron of many Greek theaters had marble seats. Skinny. The skinny, literally tent, was the building directly behind the stage. During the 5th century, the stage of the Theater of Dionysus in Athens was probably raised only 2 or 3 steps above the level of the orchestra and was perhaps 25 feet wide and 10 feet deep. The skinny was directly behind the stage and was usually decorated as a palace, temple, or other building depending on the needs of the play. It had at least one set of doors, and actors could make entrances and exits through them. There was also access to the roof of the skinny from behind, so that actors playing gods and other characters, such as the watchmen of the beginning of Aeschylus, Agamemnon, could appear on the roof if needed. Parados. The paradoi, in plural term, literally passageway, are the paths by which the chorus and some actors, such as those representing messengers or people returning from abroad, made their entrances and exits. The Odins also used them to enter and exit the theater before and after the performance. Roman Theater. The theater of the ancient Rome started in the 3rd century BC. It had varied and interesting art forms, like festival performances of the state theater, acrobatics, the staging of comedies of Plautus, and the high, verbally elaborate tragedies of Seneca. Although Rome had a native traditions of performance, the Hellenization, historical spread of ancient Greek culture, of Roman culture in the 3rd century BC, had an intense and energizing effect of the Roman theater and encouraged the development of Latin literature. According to the Roman historian Livy, in the 4th century BC, the Etruscan actors were the first to experience theater, while in 240 BC, Roman drama began with the plays of Livius Andronicus, remained popular throughout late antiquity. By the 4th century AD, 102 out of 176 ludi publici, or public games, being dedicated to theater, besides a considerably lower number of gladiator and chariot racing events. Greek theaters had a great influence on the Roman theater too. The triumvirate pompous was one of the first permanent non-wooden theaters in Rome whose structure was somewhat like the Theatrum of Athens. The building was a part of the multi-use complex that included enlarged quadriporticus or a column quadrangle. Directly behind the standing front, which is an elaborately decorated background of theater stage enclosed by the large column porticus, with an expansive garden complex of fountains and statues. There were rooms also that were dedicated to the exposition of art and other works collected by Pompeii Magnus, which were located along the stretch of covered arcade. The usual themes for Roman theater plays were chariot races, gladiators, and public executions. The Romans loved a good spectacle. They loved to watch combat, admired for blood sports and gladiator competition. The more realistic the violence, the more it would have pleased Roman audiences. The Christians, however, opposed the barbaric themes of the plays and closed all theaters. Medieval theater. During the medieval era, theater performances were not allowed throughout Europe. To keep the theater alive, minstrels, though denounced by the church, performed in markets, public places, and festivals. They traveled from one town to another as puppeteers, jugglers, storytellers, dancers, singers, and other theatrical acts. These minstrels were viewed as dangerous and pagan. Churches in Europe started staging their own theater performances during Easter Sundays with biblical stories and events. Eventually, some plays were brought outside the church using their portrayal of the devil and hell. An example of this play is the Mystery of Adam, or the Mystery of Adam. The story revolves on Adam and Eve and ends with the devil capturing and bringing them to hell. Over the centuries, the plays revolved around biblical themes, from the story of the creation to the Last Judgment. Renaissance theater. Renaissance theater arts were characterized by a return of classical Greek and Roman arts and culture. In the Middle Ages, mystery plays formed a part of religious festivals in England and other parts of Europe during the Renaissance period. Morality plays, in which the protagonist was met by personifications of various moral attributes who would try to choose a godly life over the evil, and the university drama were formed to recreate Athenian tragedy. Public theater were developed like the Commedia dell'arte, an Italian comedy and humorous theatrical presentation performed by a professional player who traveled in troops, and the elaborate masque, a dramatic entertainment consisting of pantomime, dancing, dialogue, and song, and sometimes players wore masks that were usually presented in court. One of the most prominent supporters of the theater was Queen Elizabeth I. The companies of players, or companies of actors, were organized by the aristocrats and performed seasonally in many places. They were called professional players that performed on the Elizabethan stage. The tours of these players gradually replaced the performances of the mystery and morality plays by local players. Gorboduc, authors were Thomas Norton and Thomas Sackville, also known as Ferrex and Forex, was an English play and first performed at the Christmas celebration in 1561 and performed before Queen Elizabeth I on 18th of January 1562 by the gentlemen of the Inner Temple. Was one of the four kings of court, professional association for barristers and judges in London. The famous actors and poets who emerged in this period was William Shakespeare. He was baptized on April 26, 1564 and died on April 23, 1616. He was an English poet, playwright, and actor, and regarded as the greatest writer and dramatist in the whole world. Shakespeare was often called England's national poet and the Bard of Avon. His works consist of about 38 plays. Some of these plays were well-loved Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, Midsummer Night's Dream, Cleopatra, Julius Caesar, and Much Ado About Nothing. The four tragedies considered to be Shakespeare's greatest works were Hamlet, Othello, King Lear, and Macbeth. The history plays depicted English or European history. Shakespeare's plays were about the lives of kings such as Richard III and Henry V. Comedies were common too, that dealt with life in London after the fashion of Roman New Comedy. Some of the comedy plays were The Shoemaker's Holiday by Thomas Dekker and The Chambermaid in Cheapside by Thomas Middleton. For the first time, ballet was performed in public during this period. Ballet is a formalized form of dance which originated from the Italian Renaissance courts. It developed and flourished from Italy to France with the help of Catherine de' Medici, Queen of France. An early example of Catherine's development of ballet is through Le Paradis d'Amour, a piece of work presented to her daughter's wedding, Marguerite de Valois, to Henry of Navarre. Money of the aristocrats was responsible for the initial stages of court ballet, for the aristocrats' entertainment. The first formal court ballet ever recognized was Ballet des Polonaises in 1572. A true form of royal entertainment, Ballet des Polonaises was commissioned by Catherine de' Medici to honor the Polish ambassadors who visited Paris for enthronement of King Henry in Poland. Innovation of the stage. Proscenium was developed. This is the area of the theater surrounding the stage opening. Arches frame and divide the stage from the audience. Backdrops for scenery were popularized by the art of painting clothes. Commedia dell'arte, or comedy of the profession, was developed. It was quick-witted performance of the characters or players. Baroque theater. The theater of Baroque period is marked using technology in current Broadways or commercial plays. The theater crew uses machines for special effects and scenes, changes which may be changed in a matter of seconds with the use of ropes and pulleys. This technology affected the content of the performed pieces, practicing at its best the deus ex machina, a Latin word meaning God from the machine solution, where the character gods were finally able to come down from the heavens and rescue the hero in dangerous situations. As a result, the theater was richly decorated, and the multiplicity of plot, turns, and a variety of situations characteristic of mannerism. A variety of approaches or intellectual sophistication, as well as using artificial qualities of the play, were succeeded by the opera. The use of theatrical technologies in the Baroque period may be seen in the film Battelle. Neoclassical Theater. The Neoclassical period was a movement where the styles of Romance and Greek societies influenced the theater arts. During the Neoclassical period, the theater was characterized by its grandiosity. Costumes and sceneries were highly elaborate. The main concepts of the play were to entertain and to teach lessons. Stages were restyled with dramatic arches to highlight the scenes. Multiple entry points on the stage were evident in the play. Lighting and sound effects intensified the mood and messages of each scene, enhancing the dramatic experience. The idea of changing scenery and backdrops became more noticeable, particularly with the invention of the pulley systems that allowed parts to move more quickly across the stage. The concept of decorum, which means right and proper audience behavior, was applied in this period, which means classical concepts of appropriate social behavior must be observed. This period officially established just two types of plays, tragedy and comedy. They never mixed these two together. This restriction led to the use of now well-known pair of happy and sad masks that symbolize the theatrical arts. Tragedies portrayed the complex and fateful lives of upper classes and royals, while comedies, which were either public discourse or comedies of manners, tended to focus on the lower ranks of society. Observance to these genres was critical to a play's success. Trivia about Neoclassical Theater. The first spotlight was used in the U.S. during this period was called the limelight. The Theater Regulations Act of 1843 banned drinking in legitimate theaters. Many tavern owners took advantage of the situation and renovated their establishment to accommodate live performances. Romantic theater. During Romantic period, melodrama and operas became the most popular theatrical forms. Melodrama originated from the French word melodrama, which is derived from Greek melos, or music, and French grain, which is derived from Greek grand, to perform. Melodrama can also be described as a dramatic work that puts characters in a lot of danger to appeal to the emotions, and in which orchestral music or song was used to accompany the action. Opera, on the other hand, is an art form in which singers and musicians perform a dramatic work combining text, called a libretto, and musical score. Such as acting, scenery, and costumes and dance were important elements of the theater. It is usually performed in an opera house, accompanied by an orchestra or a smaller musical ensemble. Victor Marie Hugo. Victor Marie Hugo was born on February 26, 1802, and died on May 22, 1885. He was considered as one of the greatest and best-known French writers. He was a poet, novelist, and dramatist of the Romantic movement. Hugo's literary fame comes from his poetry, novels, and his dramatic achievements. Among his works that stand out all over the world are Les Contemplations, La Légende des Cyclistes, Les Misérables, and Notre Dame de Paris, which is known as the Hunchback of Notre Dame. Quasimodo is a deformed hunchback. the bell ringer of Notre Dame, and Haradagou the harp and help Esmeralda, a beautiful gypsy street dancer with a kind and generous heart. Esmeralda captured the hearts of many men that had always wanted to own her. Georges Bizet was born on October 25, 1838, and died June 3, 1875 in Paris. Bizet was the only child of Adolphe Armand Bizet, which is formerly a hairdresser and later became a singer and composer, and Amy Marie Louise Leopoldine Josephine Del Sarte, which is a pianist. He entered the Paris Conservatory of Music a fortnight before his 10th birthday. His first symphony, the Symphony in C Major, was written when he was 17 years old. The symphony had an amazing stylistic resemblance to the music of Franz Schubert. This French composer was a pianist and best known for his operas. Carmen is the most popular among his works. Bizet composed the title role for a mezzo-soprano in the character of Carmen. The opera tells the story of the downfall of Don Jose, a naive soldier who is seduced by the charms of the sizzling gypsy, Carmen. His contemporary composers during Romantic periods were Franz Liszt, Richard Wagner, Frédéric Chopin, Ludwig van Beethoven, Franz Schubert, Felix Mendelssohn, and Hector Berlioz. Now that we finish our discussion, let us have an activity, and this is matching time. In 1 minute, match the different theater periods in column A with a corresponding description in column B. Your timer starts now. Time's up, and here are the correct answers. To sum up the different theatrical forms, we have ancient theater, and under ancient theater, we have the Greek theater. Ritual theory focus on God Dionysus performed in festivals. Sophocles and Euripides were the most popular playwrights during the ancient period. Oedipus Rex, Oedipus at Colonus, and Antigone were famous plays. Theater genre was tragedy, performed in theatron, which means viewing plays on floors of a hill. And women were not allowed to perform. Roman theater began in ancient Greek theater. Theater genre, comedy. Women began to perform. Competitions of chariots, gladiators, and public executions as a public theater. Medieval theater, mostly related to biblical stories and events. Performers go from one place to another. Renaissance theater, focus on classical Greek and Roman art and culture. Theater designs were developed, backdrops for scenery. Queen Elizabeth supported theater. Famous actors and playwrights was William Shakespeare, who wrote Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, Midsummer Night's Dream, and Cleopatra. Baroque theater used the deus ex machina to create effects in every performance. Neoclassical theater, enhanced changing of scenery and spotlight was used. Romantic period, the age of enlightenment, focus on appreciation of the exotic and primitive. Used fantastic mythical or nature-focused images. Melodrama was the genre of theater. Famous operatic composers were George Bizet of Carmen and Richard Wagner. Protagonist was rebellious, who often succeeded. Interest in the common man and childhood, and technical innovations were introduced. Let us have another activity, which is completing the table. Name the following theater building and the corresponding theater period. Identify the description or characteristics of the building. You will be given 15 seconds to think your answer in each number on our comment section. Image number 1. Image number 1, named amphitheater. Theater period, ancient Greek period. Description or characteristics of the building, it has theatron, orchestra, skinny, and parodos. It built at the side of the hill. Image number 2. Image number 2, named Triumvir Pompeii. Theater period, ancient Roman period. Descriptions or characteristics of the building. It is a permanent non-wooden theater in Rome. The building was part of a multi-use complex. Image number 3. Image number 3, named proscenium. Theater period, Renaissance period. Description or characteristics of the building. It has art on the stage to provide atmosphere and a sense of spectacle and scene changes. Image number 4. Number 4, named Teatro Regio Torino. Theater period, Baroque period. Description or characteristics of the building. Auditorium has magnificent decorations, impressive scenes, and technical equipment. Image number 5. Number 5, named Neoclassical Theater in Moscow. Theater period, Neoclassical period. Description or characteristics of the building. It has dramatic arches to highlight scenes, with multiple entry points on the stage, and also changing scenery and backdrops are noticeable. Once again, this is Sir Harrold, your art teacher, and leaving you a Jack's quote in his line from Act 2, Scene 7 of Shakespeare's As You Like It. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven pages. Our world is like a play or a stage, and all men and women are really actors or players on this stage called the world. All the people enter this world through different routes and exit on a different route. They enter the stage when they are born and live it when they die. During this entire lifespan, every person plays different parts of roles. And these parts are known as seven stages, which are like different acts of drama or play. Keep safe, everyone, and see you in our next live streaming session.